Given that context, just how damaging is the UK's exit to the EU?
So I don't think the EU is going to find, in an economic sense, that the difficulties are really noticeable. Where I think they will find a bigger difference is in the whole defence security role and the foreign policy role. I think it's fair to say that Britain has always been at the forefront of foreign policy in Europe since it joined the EU, precisely for the reasons I've already given. We're used to thinking globally. We're used to acting globally. In defence, we are, amongst all the European members of NATO, the one who spends most on defence and the one who has the most sophisticated equipment and so on. It's a bit the same on the intelligence side. We are certainly better at intelligence than any of the European countries are. They're going to be weakened by our departure, unless they're prepared to bring us back in some of their institutions and the way they do these things. So it's not so much the economic side where they're going to miss Britain. It's going to be on police, intelligence, security, and defence.
What about businesses? What about multinational companies looking to invest in Europe? How should they be thinking with the current landscape of, you know, a combative trade position and these local spats that are happening at the moment?
I believe that the level of investment will increase. What will deter it, if anything does, will be additional regulatory burdens in Europe, which discourage foreign investment from anywhere. It doesn't have to be Britain. It can be from any part of the world. And that's always a bit of a risk at Europe. It's not been as good at lightening and easing regulation as we have. They need to learn from that, to be perfectly honest. There's a great tendency in Brussels to add complicated regulation to so much of business. And that'll damage them more than anyone else.
I'm going to ask you to look into your crystal ball and ask, what does the EU look like in 10 years' time?
You'll see Europe develop differing levels of membership. Some countries will go the whole way. They'll go for a European-wide budget, a European finance ministry, and so on, but not all of them. There'll be others who will remain in a, you could call it an outer circle or a lower level, whatever. So it will become a more varied institution instead of one single entirely cohesive block. And I suspect that is the way it will go. That would be my vision of it. It won't be a single colossus, nor will it start to break up, but it will be a mixed organization, different levels of cooperation. And interestingly, you know, that is what the vision of Margaret Thatcher was about Europe, which she delivered many, many years ago in the Bruges speech, a Europe which had kept some powers for the individual member states, handed over to Europe what we could do better together than individually, but not hand over all powers. So maybe that will actually, in the end, come true, even though Margaret Thatcher won't sadly be there to see it.
You have a unique perspective on that famous moment when she delivered that Bruges speech in 1988. Some have heralded that as the moment the UK was put on the path to Brexit. Would you agree with that?
Margaret Thatcher's Bruges speech did not set off Brexit. What it tried to do was to describe a different vision for Europe. A Europe where I've just said, which kept more national powers but worked together, where you could do things more effectively together. A Europe which made much greater efforts to be a free trader and maintain a great relationship across the North Atlantic with the United States. A Europe which brought in the East European countries, who at that stage was still under communism, and made them part of this wider Europe. That's what the Bruges speech was about. Nothing to do with leaving Europe. Now, obviously, some of the same people who were very unhappy with the way that the European Union worked went on to become Brexiteers and to campaign for us to leave altogether. But that was never her vision nor her idea.